Do now, Mark.
I know what we're gonna do. We're gonna call the filth. Car.
Hammond. I'm at the depot. Jake's just about to leave. He's got half the Bethnal Greenwood with him. I need some backup.
I don't give a shit. Charlie's just took off with Alex. You get the flying squad. I've got to get my boy.
I'm off the squad, Hammond. I'm suspended. My boss, the bastard you executed, he belonged to Charlie. Unless I get the Jolsons, I've got no way of clearing my name.
So what, copper? Don't tell me your troubles. Every cop, every villain in London wants me dead. And I've got to get my boy.
You agreed, Hammond. It's you and me now. Going up against him.
You don't owe him anything, Mark.
Listen, Hammond. Jake must be heading for the meeting. Charlie intends to sort out all the loose ends.
Yeah? So where's he going?
To some old cargo ship called Sol Vita at St. Saviour's Dock. He's going to take care of everyone.
Are you winding me up? What's he going there for?
What do you think? They're taking your kid there. Charlie was going to deliver you to all the other gangs. He's out to finish it. Charlie's gonna blow the whole thing sky high, Hammond, so you better get there.
Shut it, copper. I'll keep my word. We're on our way, all right?
Right, go for the kid. I'll go for Jake and the detonator.
A fast car would be good.
In London, it ain't what you drive, it's who's driving.
Well, you certainly know how to show a girl a good time.
Thank you.
find Alex, and then I'll take care of Harry, Charlie, the lot.
Let's get there first. Get the boy and get out.
Bethany, we need to lose him now.
We've got.
Behind. Maybe down the next turning. This ain't a game, Hammond. Come on, be serious. This ain't a game, Hammond. Come on, be serious. What the fuck are you doing? Come on, I thought you were a pro. Charlie's mine. I've got to get to him before anyone else.
All right, Yez. I'm going down here after Alex.
Evan, you're
here. Yeah, I'm here.
Come on.
How you feeling?
Going for the set. Oh, man, once this one's done, I've only got the little boy.
Unlucky, eh?
Jeez. too good for you, Emmon. Emmon, come to Harry. It's all over now, son. She gave up singing for a piece of shit like you.
What are you on about, Harry? Susie? Come on, maggot. Fucking Muppet. It's all over, Harry. Alex! Alex!
Dad, I thought you were dead!
Oh, thank Christ you're okay.
Charlie's bomb. You could blow up half of London with that thing. Don't worry, it's not activated. But I'd love to know who's got the detonator. What took you so long anyway?
Harry, he's making amends with his maker.
That lecherous prick eyebrows got some of the same.
You seen Charlie or Jake?
We don't have to worry about Psycho Jake anymore.
The bomb's over here. In all that carnage, they forgot to detonate it.
We don't think they still won't. Where's the remote? There's a detonator loose on the super junk. And where the hell's Charlie?
Who cares? You've got your kid. We're all still alive. Now let's get the hell out of here.
Well, that might be okay for you, but it's time London did without all the Jolsons.
He's right here if you want him, cos I dropped the piece. You as well, crazy man. Well, it finally looks like we've got all our problems under one roof, doesn't it? Fat Man arranges a meeting. It's supposed to be a demilitarised zone. And as soon as we sit down, guns start going off all over the place. Now, we think the Fat Man might be showing a little bit of bad faith. Especially considering all the trouble we've been having with this vigilante over there. And then we find our man here trying to sneak off the boat. We come down here and find it's like a fucking slaughterhouse. Good job. I brought my boys along. Somebody better start telling me what the fuck's going on here. Otherwise, there's gonna be a lot more claret spilt aboard this ship.
I can explain, Nick. I can explain everything.
Explain. Fucking explain! I should hope you care for your sake, son. You've got quite a few people here would like some serious words with you.
Nick, let him speak, man. Let's find out what the hell's been going on here.
I should just kill you. God knows I would. You have caused me a lot of grief, Emmett.
Nick, come on, man. Let's hear him out. Let's hear what he's got to say. You're surely not going to listen to this fucking National Front lunatic.
What I tell you, I arranged this meeting to hand over the boy who's been causing you all this problem. He's caused you all an injury. He topped your people, Collins. And here he is, delivered on a silver fucking platter. Just like I promised.
Shut it, Fat Man. You promised me the situation would be cool. No heavies. And the ship did a crawl with your boy then. You promised me the crazy man. Instead, we have to come down here and fight him for himself. Think think the best solution for the problem after we just do, you know. You say China, man.
Satoko.
Mr. Bobbily agrees. Kill him now.
Are you all blind? Can't you see what's going on here?
Let the boy go, Nick. I'll take what's coming. It's not his fault. Let the boy and the girl go. All it's ever been about is the boy. Just hear me out.
I'm listening.
He killed Susie, Nick. Right in the street, in front of my gaff. He kidnapped Alex and blackmailed me into doing jobs all over town. The only part I couldn't figure out was why he was having me taking turns in hitting you, then you, and then you. I did it. I admit it. And I'll take what's coming. But I was protecting my boy. And he deserves a chance, doesn't he?
Continue. This story is very interesting.
He played us all like a game of chess. Sending me against you, and then watching you take chunks out of each other. While he sat back and smoked his fat fucking cigar.
I'll bring out the fucking violins. You're breaking my bleeding heart. You can't seriously be listening to this mad tosser. He killed his wife. I took his kid in out of my respect for his Susie. He's gone loop the fucking loop.
Why do you think he brought you all here? To give you Mark Hammond? Someone would have got to him eventually. We all know that. Either you guys or the police. Who do you think has benefited the most from all this strife? Who would like all of you lot out the way so that things were just like the good old days? And who would be mad enough to plant a bomb that would blow up half the waterfront just to make sure he had no rivals?
Oh, I saw you steer, fat man. You prefer them old days without competition. You say you have to help we with our problem. But all the while, it's a joke thing you have played upon me. You have to block the whole town with that.
You are a fucking dinosaur, Charlie!
This is the new millennium. We make more money on porno on the internet than you ever made in the knocking shops of Soho. London is multicultural. It always was. Only people like you never realised it. I mean, you're like a bad hangover from a different era. An era that's about to end.
I'm letting you go, Mark. You earn a boy. Look. I know what you did. And I know why you did it. But it still don't make it right, does it? I lost some good lads because of you. Lads that I'm gonna miss. Now, I'm letting you go, son. Get out of London and get out tonight. And don't let me ever see your face in this town again. Do you hear me?
You've spoken out of place, Mr. Collins. This man has killed many men, and he has been very bad for business.
I ask this as a favour, Mr. Lee. He done it for his kid, and I'd have done the same for mine.
But you're from Hammond, We are prepared to recognize his favor and, well, at the proper time, ask a favor in return.
Now, you gonna give me a problem over this?
This boy, him kill me boy them and steal my money. So me not really too happy about him still alive. And I want the people them to think he can mess with Jamal and be taking liberties. However, for the sake of our little racial unity, I'm prepared to let him and him boy go free. Now move!
Now, you heard him, Hammond. Now get the fuck out of here and don't let me ever see your face in this town again. Do you hear?
Now we can have some fun with his lordship here.
I'll miss you, big boy. But whatever you do, don't cry. I don't think you'll be getting much sympathy here.
What about the cop, Nick? He's been straight up.
Shut it, Mark. You're pushing your luck. I gave you a break because of Seuss, but I'll never go out on a limb for the filth. I can't have the filth knowing my business.